Thank you for joining me. Let's discuss creating a 360 CMA inside of the Matrix platform. Creating a comparative market analysis or CMA presentation for your current and potential clients is one of the most important tools to any realtor. It's an appealing, informative demonstration of your local area knowledge and expertise, and it can impress your clients and earn their trust. Now, even more powerful, Matrix 360 CMA is a new enhancement that allows agents to search non-listed or off-market properties within the Realist Tax Data to be used as comparables. Now, typically, there's three ways to create a CMA within the Matrix system. We'll begin today by coming to the top navigation, My Matrix, and from the dropdown, we're going to go into the CMA section here. This is where we go when we want to manage our CMAs. Notice, along the left, I can reveal a dropdown beside a CMA and choose to edit, view, email, or delete the CMA. Additionally, along the bottom, this is where I'll go when I want to start a new CMA. One thing to note, CMAs will be saved in Matrix for a period of 180 days. Now, clicking on Start New CMA will jump me into the CMA wizard. This will take me step by step in each section until I build my CMA report. We begin here in the first section called Start, where we're going to select our contact to associate the CMA to. I'll go ahead and say my client. Note, I can create a new contact on the fly along the right. Next, I'll select my CMA type. We're going to take it into a Matrix 360 property so that we can build a Matrix 360 CMA, which allows us to search for non-listed or off-market properties within the Realist Tax Data. I can provide a description for the CMA. We move on to the next section, which are pages. And in pages, along the left are all of my available pages. And along the right are my selected pages that are going to be applied to the report. Now, along the left in available pages, these include elements to include in the report, such as a cover sheet, or for the subject and adjustments, or for the comps, or any stats. Additionally, at the bottom, this is where we can upload our own custom pages to include in our CMA report. Now, once I make a selection on an available page, we're going to find that it jumps to our selected pages section. Feel free to maneuver or remove a particular page along the right. Let's move on to the next section, which is subject, where we're going to identify our subject property. Now, we can input all of the fields manually, identify the property by a listing ID, or search using a Matrix 360 property search. This is utilizing the tax data. And I'm going to input my street number for my subject property, as well as the street name. This is going to allow me to pull in and autofill some of the tax data. Let me also input my subject property city. I'll go ahead and select results along the bottom so that I can pull in my subject property. Now I can verify that this is my subject property on this one line by going through some of the details. If it is, then along the left, I'll click on that property, and from the bottom, I'll fill from selected. Again, this is going to pull in some of the tax details into the property. Note, it pulled in the address and some of the features. Now, along the right, I can choose to include a property photo and even upload one from my computer, as well as being able to leave remarks on this CMA. Now we're finished in this section. Let's move on to the next, which is cover. Here I'll be able to select my subject cover photo and similarly upload one from my computer. I can review the contacts information as well as my agent information. Feel free to edit your information for each CMA you build. Let's move on to the next section, which is comparables. This is where we'll select what comparables we want to add to the CMA. Now, we can add from a cart, or we can add from listings. Let's go ahead and build a search here. is going to pull open that same tax search. I'll go ahead and remove my subject property address. Now I'll keep the same city. Now I'm going to select additional criteria where along the left, I'll choose statuses. Perhaps I'll select active to show my client what homes are currently selling for. Perhaps I'll also select closed to show them what homes recently sold for. Note, once I select an off-market date, a day range will propagate. Now, this is telling the system to go back and search from 0 to 180 days. This might be too broad and pull up too many results for me. Let's go ahead and narrow it down. I'm going to tell the system to just search from everything from 0 to 30 days. Now, of course, we're building a 360 CMA. So along the bottom, we have the ability to select a non-MLS sale. And similarly, I'll go ahead and change this day range. Now, along the right, I'll get specific with a property type and a property subtype. And as I scroll down, I have the ability to input additional characteristics, such as bedrooms. We'll go ahead and say 3 or more, or choose to pull a range. And similarly for bathrooms, or we can choose to pull a range. We'll go ahead and input your characteristics. And at the bottom, we'll go ahead and pull the results. This is going to bring all of those comps into the report. Now, we're going to have to select specifically which comps we want to add and which comps we want to remove. Here is where I'll do all of my research, either on this one line or by clicking into the MLS number, I'll be able to see that full 360 view. Now I'm going to go ahead and sort this by status. Just by clicking on status, now I can sort, making it a little bit easier for me to make my selections. I'll probably choose active and some closed, as well as some of those non-MLS sales. Once I've made my selections, I'll go ahead and select Add Selected below. Now I can be sure that I'm only going to see these comps inside of my CMA. We're finished in this section, so let's go ahead and move on to the next, which is Map. Now there's nothing particular in the Map section. Here is just we'll see a static of our subject property surrounded by our comps. If you added the adjustments page, we can head to the adjustments section. Now, what are adjustments? This is the ability to increase or decrease a home's displayed price by adjusting the known facts. Next, we move on to pricing. This is going to give you a summary of your comparable prices, a low, median, average, and high. You also receive additional analysis and you can choose to input a suggested list price. An alternative is to leave this space blank. You can write in by hand when you meet the client. Also, you can apply any notes or additional comments which should appear with the price. Finished in this section, and we're finished with our CMA. Now that we're finished, you can choose to view the CMA or email the CMA out. Let's go ahead and take a look at the CMA that we've just built. Now, while that's generating, remember, we can go back and manage all of our CMAs from the top menu, dropping into CMAs. For more information and updates on CMAs, be sure to follow us on social media and connect with us, or head to crmls.org.